Welcome to Nerdbots guys. So today we are going to create a password protected security system. For this we are going to use 4x4 keypad matrix and Arduino Uno as microcontroller. For the coding part and simulation part, I am going to use an online tool, Tinkercad, for this. So just type Tinkercad on Google. Okay, click on the very first link. Let's get. So it has redirected me to the dashboard because I have already logged in. So in case you haven't, just log in here from here. So in the project section, click on create project and click on that project. From this drop down, select the circuit. So it will open the workspace for you. Okay, so this is my workspace, and in the right you can see this component section, from where you can select the components which you needed for the project. So for this particular project, first component which I needed is this Arduino. Okay, now I need a keypad. So it's a 4x4 keypad matrix. Okay, now for the indication purpose, I will be using two LEDs, one of red color and other one is of green color, to indicate whether the user has entered the correct password or not. Okay, so just drag these two LEDs here. You can change the color of a particular LED by just clicking on it and select the color. Now I have two different colored LEDs. Okay, now we know that every LED has two terminals, cathode and anode. Cathode is a negative terminal, so it should be connected to the ground. Similarly, I will connect the cathode of green LED to ground. Now I will be needing two resistors, one for each LED. Okay, so just connect these two the resistor to the anode terminal. Now I can set the value of this resistor, so I will be using 220 ohm resistance. So just select it once again. Okay, make it also 220 ohm. Okay, now I'm going to connect this red LED to 13th pin and the green one to 11th pin. Now this keypad matrix has 8 terminals. The first 4 ones are for each of the 4 rows and the other 4 ones are for these 4 columns. Okay, I'm going to connect these from left to right in sequence. Okay, so the last one will be connected to the third pin. Okay, so this was it for the circuit part. Now let's move on to the coding part. To open the code editor, just click on this code. So this is the block view of your program, but I need the text view. So select the text and continue. So this is the sample code which Tinkercad has provided me, but I do not need this, so just get rid of it, as I have already coded the program for it. So I'm just pasting it over here. Now let's see how this program works. Okay, so on the very top I have included keypad header file which will help me to get the key value which have been pressed. Okay, now this is the number rows variable, which is storing the number of rows which I have on the keypad, and similarly the number of columns is also 4. Now this is the key map matrix. Okay, what it is doing, it is just mapping the 4x4 keypad into this matrix. It has having the same values as each of the rows of this keypad matrix has. Okay, now row pins. What is row pins? Row pins is the array which is holding the pin numbers to which each of the row is connected. So you can see that my each of the row has been connected to 10, 9, 8, 7, and 6. 10, 9, 8, and 7 pin. Okay. Similarly, my columns has been connected to 6, 5, 4, and 3rd pin. Now I need to initialize the keypad class in order to use its built-in functions. So I'm initializing it. So just call the constructor, and in constructor pass the key map matrix, the pin numbers to which rows are connected, the column, the pin numbers to which columns are connected, the number of rows the keypad matrix has, and the number of columns it has. Now this is the password string which will be holding our previously set password by user. Okay, now what is this void setup? Void setup is a function which will be holding the statements which are to be executed only once. So all of the statements inside the void setup will be executed only at the very beginning of the program. So what is this pin mod 13 output? So what this function does is that it sets that particular pin number to this mode. Okay, output mode. So it can be input, but as I'm using all these GPIOs in the output mode, so I have defined all the pins in output mode. Okay, what does this serial dot begin mean? So the whole program will be interacting with the user through the serial monitor only. So in order to do that, this this program has to communicate with the serial monitor. So it has to begin the serial communication with it, and this 9600 is the baud rate. It is basically the data rate with which the communication will take place. Okay, so it needs to be set it previously, because otherwise there will be some data loss. So after all that setup, firstly our program will ask for the user to set his 4-digit password. So as the digit has four, as the password has 4 digits, I need to read all digits one by one. So that's why I use a while loop which will iterate for 4 times. Now I can extract the key value which have been pressed by using my object which I have defined here, and just call the member function getKey. So it will give me the character corresponding to that button which have been clicked. Okay, so if actually the key has been pressed, I will append that character to my password string. And this, what is the meaning of incrementing this numEntered? So numEntered is keeping the record of how many digits have been entered by the user till now. Okay, so I need to increment it in order to maintain maintain the password as a 4-digit. Okay, it should not go beyond that. Okay, when the user has entered the 4-digit password, we will prompt it that the password has been set successfully, and from there we can ask the user that he can input the password. So enter your password. Now this was our setup function. Now this is while loop. While loop is just like your while one loop. It will run forever. Okay, so it is the variable pass tried. It is keeping track of the number of trials the user has wasted, or the number of times the user has successively entered the wrong password. Okay, I have set it the threshold to be 3. So it means that if user entered password incorrectly successively for the 3 times, then this loop will break. So for each trial, we will read the four characters of the password, and if the password entered by the user is same as the previously set password, then we will prompt that the password is correct, and the green LED will lit up for the next 5 seconds. So this delay will pause the code over here for 5 seconds. Okay, and after 5 seconds, the code below it will get executed. So after 5 seconds, the green LED will be low, and the user can again enter the password. Okay, so this will go on. Now, what if the user has entered a wrong password? If user has entered the wrong password, we will increment the number of trials user has wasted. Okay, and we will blink the LED. So what this line is doing is that first it is making the red LED high, then it is waiting for 1 second, and then it is making it low. So it's a kind of blinking, and it will prompt the user that you have entered a wrong password. So actually it should be above that. Okay, otherwise there will be 1 second delay in getting the notification. Okay, what if the user has entered all his 3 trials? So if the user has entered the password consecutively wrong for 3 times, then the red LED will be glown, and the program will wait for 10 seconds. It means the red LED will be glown for 10 seconds, and after that the red LED will be off, and the user can again enter the password. So this was the basic program flow. I hope that you understood it. Now we are done with the circuit part and the coding part. Now let's dive into the simulation. So for simulating it, just click on this start simulation, and it will flash the code here into this microcontroller. So you can see that simulator time has begun. It means code has been uploaded successfully. So just click on this serial monitor here. So it is showing up that set your 4-digit password. So I am setting it as 4444, 4 times 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now my password has been set successfully. Now I can guess the password or enter my password. Okay, what if I enter a wrong password? Okay, it's a bit slow, so it is not taking my inputs properly. I need to click multiple times in order to get that. Okay, now it says that you have entered an incorrect password, and you must have noticed that this red LED blinks. Okay, what if I enter a wrong password again? Okay, you can see that the red LED has been glown, and it prompted me that I have entered a wrong password again. Now what if I enter the wrong password for the third time? So see, now the red LED is remain glowing, so it will be in same state for 10 seconds. Just wait. Okay, now it the 10 seconds have been passed, so the red LED is off now. Okay, what if I enter the correct password? So my correct password was 4 times 4. It's not taking my click. Okay, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now you can see that the green LED has been glown, and see, we had a stop time of 5 seconds. Okay, so now it is confirmed that our program is working correctly. Okay, so we are done with it. Our project has been completed. So that was it for this video, guys. The link for the code is in the description below, and you can refer from there. Thank you, guys.